This experiment demonstrates another aspect of electromagnetic induction. This time, however, we're going to use an AC supply. So what we have here is an electromagnet. We have a very thick iron core, and that's to produce a strong extended magnetic field. Now, at the moment, there's no current flowing through that, so there's no magnetic field. We have an aluminum ring that we place over the iron core like that. When we press this button here, that sets up the current, that in turn creates a magnetic field, and does that. One more time. What is actually going on there is that the alternating magnetic field there induces an alternating magnetic field in here, which is opposed to the original magnetic field. So in other words, you've got North Pole facing North Pole or South Pole facing South Pole. That reproduces a repulsive effect, and hence the ring is shot into the air. We can demonstrate this a couple of other ways. Supposing I keep my hand over the top. You notice what we have here is levitation. In fact, the ring is being suspended in the air, and you may even be able to hear the noise. This is the AC circuit producing a vibration in the windings. It's a bad idea to do this for a long time because the ring is actually carrying quite a large current and actually gets pretty warm. That's magnetic induction heating. To show you this is real, let's redo this experiment. Another aluminum ring, press the button, nothing happens. Why? What's the difference? The difference is that this ring has a break in it. It can't carry a current round it, in other words. So since there's no, you can't have an induced current in the secondary, you can't have a magnetic field, and you don't see any levitation. One final aspect of this I'd like to show you uses this. Here, in fact, we have a large number of coils of wire. They're hidden under this tape. And it's hooked up to, again, a flashlight battery. We'll put that on top. And now, when I turn on the button, you'll notice the light lights up. So what we have here is a magnetic field that's produced by the electromagnet. The iron core concentrates it, and it produces the magnetic field inside this, which is effectively a secondary circuit. The secondary circuit carries enough current in this case to illuminate the bulb. If we can get it to like that. In fact, what this device is a very primitive transformer. We're taking a current in a primary coil and inducing a current in a secondary coil. It's a very bad transformer, a very inefficient transformer, but it's the principle that's important in this case.